Good morning and Happy New Year. We welcome you to St. Joseph's Episcopal Church with open arms and with open hearts. Please be reverent while we worship. We encourage you to fully participate in our service with responses and with song, but ask that you do so with your device muted. Please use the chat to add your prayers, thanksgivings, and petitions so that we may include them in the service. Thank you.
Come, Happy New Year. Happy, happy New Year. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you that you have seen us through 2022, and we bow down before you, trusting that you will continue to guide us in this new year to come, and a lot of exciting things will happen to us as individuals, as a family, and as a church. Good morning, St. Joseph and friends. I'm the Reverend Judith Alexis. I have been the supply priest for St. Joseph while Mother Ellis was on sabbatical. This morning, just as I started, I'm ending with Miss Julius Charles Rawlings being the voice of the people.
And we ask that today, as you enter your prayers, thanksgivings, and petitions in the chat, please include the names of those loved ones who passed in 2022 so that we may include them in the service.
Sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. This is Christ, the King, whom shepherds guard and name.
Dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Hallelujah to us.
Hallelujah. To us, a child is born.
Come, let us adore him. Hallelujah. Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is good. He himself had made us, and we are his and his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And his faithfulness endures from age to age.
Psalm 8. O Lord, our governor, how exalted is your name in all the world. Out of the mouths of infants and children, your majesty is praised above the heavens. You have set up a stronghold against your adversaries to quell the enemy and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars you have set in their courses, what is man that you should be mindful of him? The son of man that you should seek him out? You have made him but little lower than the angels. You adorn him with glory and honor. You give him mastery over the works of your hands. You put all things under his feet, all sheep and oxen, even the wild beasts of the field. The birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatsoever walks in the paths of the sea. O Lord, our governor, how exalted is your name in all the world. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The first reading.
The Old Testament reading of Numbers chapter 6, verses 22 to 27. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, thus you shall bless the Israelites. He shall say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and to be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. So they shall put my name on the Israelites, and I will bless them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You are the You are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in glory of God the Father.
Amen.
A reading from Paul's letter to the church in Galatia, chapter 4, verses 4 to 7. When the fullness of the time had come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because we are children, God has sent the Son, the Spirit of his Son, into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plain, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strain. Gloria in excelsis.
A reading from the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke, second chapter, verses 15 to 21. When the angels had left them and gone in heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherd told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God and all they had heard and seen, and all it had been told to them. After 8 days had passed, it was the time to circumcise the child. He was called Jesus, the name given by the angels before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Brothers and sisters, good morning. Hope you had a wonderful, wonderful evening last night. What can I say? What's in a name? Today is the feast, it's Holy Name. What is in a name? Now, if you are like me, I am very picky about my name. My name is Judith. It's not Judy. It's not Jay. It's Judith. So we understand more than anything today what means the holy name. When a group of people decided to give you your name, and naming somebody is never an easy process. It's always a conversation. Even if the person is a single parent, there's a conversation with themselves. What name am I going to give this child to fully embody what the wish and the hope that I have for this child? In my case, my father had to fight four women to get the name that he wanted, because everybody had an option. My father, who is not biblical, went to get my name from the Bible. That's how big the fight was. And it's the same thing for you. The person or people or persons who name you took great care at choosing this name for you. Now, the holy name of Jesus is, first of all, it started with the Roman Catholic Church around 1500s. Martin Luther for the Protestant Church is really the person who said, "Wait a second, we need to pay attention to that." And I forgot the year, but he discussed it in one of his works, one of the Trees, and I forgot the year, but this is where it came forth for us who are more on the Protestant side. In the Jewish religion, there's the circumcision in 8 days, and that's why you also name your child. For us, well, in modern time, depending on where you live, the moment you come out, the first thing they ask you, they hand you your baby, boy or girl, what's the name? And before you get out of the hospital, you will have a name for that child. In certain countries, since the birth certificate is not made the same day, sometimes it'll take the parents have weeks and months to go down the mountain and find somebody to do the birth certificate. But even when they give you your name, that special legal name, most people in your family have a nickname for you. And in some cases, they use the nickname so much that sometimes the child doesn't know the real name, and the only time the real name show up is at school. And even then, sometime the school uses the nickname. So you know, brothers and sisters, how big is a name. The holy name of Jesus Christ is so important to us that depending on your church theology, no, church liturgical practices, every time we say Jesus, some of us, what do? We bow our heads. That is how important it is to us. And sometimes I find myself preaching and then I forget to mention Jesus, which is so bad. Because that name is us. That name is you. And that name was chosen from him since the Old Testament. This is who he's going to come. He's the Emmanuel. He's like with us. And his name will be Jesus. Brothers and sisters, I hope in this new year, you search and understand how important is that word for us, that name Jesus Christ. Some people are dying now because they cannot mention Jesus Christ. Some people are in hiding because, and by the way, this is not in other countries. This is in this country. Because if you go to work in certain settings, you cannot mention Jesus. You cannot have a cross up. You cannot have a cross on you. Now, I do believe in the diversity of the world. I clearly, sincerely believe in the diversity of the world. But sometimes we forget to mention the name of Jesus in our everyday affairs. Sometimes I forget. I talk about the personality. I talk about the character. But I forget to mention Jesus in my teachings, in my sermons. So today, more than any other day, this is the one that was foretold. This is the name that was chosen. This is the name that survived the centuries. That holy name, Jesus Christ, our Lord. So like the shepherds, like the angels who announce who's coming, go see him. He's in a manger. He's a child. You will see him with Mary, Joseph, go. Don't forget that we believe in Jesus Christ, the Son that came down from us. But the other part of the holy name of Jesus is Mary and Joseph. Because if you name a child and you don't take care of him or her, what's the point? If you name a child and you don't nurture that child, you know, My name is Judith, and the older I get, the older I realize that they nurtured Judith. I'm bold, just like Judith in the Bible. And look at your name. You know where your name came from. Somebody's told your story. Whether it's true or not, it doesn't matter. Somebody told you how you got your name. Even if you were adopted, somebody told you how you got your name. Look at that name. Fulfill all the aspiration and the aspiration of that name to the fullest. If they told you they chose your name because you were bold, because they believe that you'll do great things. Trust and continue to be bold and do great things until the end. Yes, you will have obstacles. Yes, sometimes you're gonna have to flee. Yes, sometimes people, shepherds will appear out of, you don't know even know them. They will appear and guide you. They will appear and be in awe of you. And you'll be like, why? I'm not doing anything special. No, because that is you. That is what God has put in you. Just because you don't see it, allow the shepherds in your life, allow the your parents, not just your biological parents, but everybody who is parenting you, even your children, allow them to see what God, what spirit God has put in you, brothers and sisters. Like last night, I told the joke about the mirror. In certain department stores, there's a special type of mirror where when you try your clothes on, you look great because you look thinner. It's a special mirror. It plays with the angles. So don't use that mirror. Don't use the mirror that you want to see in your head. Use the true mirror, the mirror, the friends, the shepherds, all these people God has put into your environment so you could fully fulfill your name. Because that's what happened to Jesus. God put everybody in Jesus' environment until the end for him to fulfill this holy name. Brothers and sisters, I know, and I'm going to be cocky this morning because I trust. I know that God has put into your environment everything you need. And by the way, when I say everything, it's not just good. It's good and bad. It's positive and negative. You need that balance. Because Jesus had it, you know. Disciples, people looking to kill him. Disciples and people who did kill him. But he fulfilled his name to the end. Brothers and sisters, yes, your name was chosen and blessed. Take full ownership of it. Don't stifle yourself. You were blessed, chosen for specific purpose. And your name was chosen for that purpose. And it's not just you as an individual, as individuals, but it's you as St. Joseph Episcopal Church in Queens Village. You know, your name was not random. A group of people prayed about it and voted on it. Bishop had to approve it. So that special name given to you as the group, please work together. Have think beyond whatever small box you have in your head. Think beyond whatever obstacles you see, and together fulfill what the name of Saint Joseph, the qualities of Saint Joseph: adoption, welcoming, blindly trusting that God is guiding you. Blindly listening to God, because that's what St. Joseph did. He blindly listened to the angel the first time the Mary's pregnant, and also the second time, get up, get out of here, go. So brothers and sisters, this is the message I'm leaving with you this morning as we celebrate the holy name of Jesus. Your name was not an accident. The name of your church was not an accident. People prayed, people agonized over it. It is now your time, your turn to fulfill it to the fullest, just as an example Jesus Christ of Nazareth did. Amen. Let us profess our faith in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord.
And grant us your salvation.
Close your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon the earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Let us pray. Lord God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this new day, this new year. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin, nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord God, Heavenly Father, in you will live and move and have our being. We humbly pray you so to guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that in all the cares and occupation of our life, we would not forget you, but may remember that we are ever walking in your sight. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
O God, the King eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into morning, drive far from us all wrong desires, incline our hearts to keep our law, and guide our feet into the way of peace. And having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal Father, you gave your incarnate Son the holy name of Jesus to be the sign of our salvation. Plant in every heart, we pray, the love of him who is the Savior of the world, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God in glory everlasting.
Amen.
Sisters and brothers, let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus. With humble hearts, let us say to the Lord, Lord Jesus, we bow our hearts at your name. Jesus, we exalt your name in all the world. Bless your church. Inspire us by the Holy Spirit to confess you as Lord over all we are, all we do, and all we hope to do. Lord Jesus,
we bow our hearts at your name.
Jesus, we exalt your name in all the world. Bless the people of the world. May the whole world experience your peace. Lord Jesus,
we bow our hearts at your name.
Jesus, we exalt your name in all the world. Bless our planet. Make us faithful stewards of all the works of your fingers. Forgive us when we fail to respect your creatures, the beasts of the field, the birds of the air, and the fish of the sea. Lord Jesus,
we bow our hearts at your name.
Jesus, we exalt your name in all the world. Bless our city and our region. Give us renewed hope and purpose as we begin this new year. Lord Jesus,
we bow our hearts at your name.
Jesus, we exalt your name in all the world. Bless the sick and the lonely and all those in great need. Make your face to shine on them and be gracious to them. Lord Jesus,
we bow our hearts at your name.
Jesus, we exalt your name in all the world. Bless the dying and the dead. We praise you that through your death on the cross, you have earned for us everlasting life. Lord Jesus,
we bow our hearts at your name.
O Lord, your mercy endures forever. Hear the prayers of your people and grant us strength and the courage to walk in your ways all the days of our lives. In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Amen.
And Tabitha Parrington gives thanks and praise to the Almighty in thanksgiving for her cousin Dawn Jones, who celebrates her birthday today on January 1st. May God continue to bless her.
O God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray, on your servant as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace. Strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their lives. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
We continue to pray for all those in our community who have lost family and friends, and ask Almighty God to bestow grace upon them during this year. Let us pray for the souls of those who passed, that they may rest in peace and rise in glory, and that their memories be a blessing to those who love them. Errol Byfield. Edmund Chung. Gurley DeLeon. Petronella Harvey. Grace Allison James Simmon. Harold Lowe Sr. Henry Perryman. Deborah Phillips Julian. Gary Sutherland. Tamara Sutherland Francis. Mona Walters. Raymond White. We pray for the Republic of Haiti as they celebrate their 219th year of independence today on January 1st. May the Lord bless and protect the country and its people.
Pray for the following people in a prayer list: Janelle Adams, Daphne Aguero, Keisha Alexander, Michael and Gloria, Melissa Harrington Harvard, Audrey Otters, Sonia Barton, Allison Brown Cunningham, Idris Bryant, the Byfield family, Rose Garrett, Anne Marie Chambers, Dorna, Charles, Marina, Marina, and Percival Chester, Sadie Curtis, Perpetua and Randolph Ellis, Yolanda Evans Humber, Karima Swerves, Fitzroy Gabadon. Claudette and Anthony Grant, Hiroshi Yasa, Doriel Holness, James Hunter, Natalie Hunt Lavinstone, Norma Jarrett, Afua Johnson, Kim Chow Jones, Pietra Jones, Noel Khan, Charles Kozakiewicz, John Lake, Sister Sheila Marie, Rosalind Merrickle, Sandy Michael, Carlton Mitchell, Crystal Nurse, Lucille Nurse, Kathleen Nurse Lewis, Verily Powerful, Hortense Reed, Chandra Robinson, Shelley Robinson, Sheila Sams, Joy Saunders, Rosa Segovia, Walter Simpson, Patsy Stevenson, Desmond St. Louis, Maureen Ty, Peter Tavolacci, George Upshaw, Marilyn Warwell, and Pat Winter. Heavenly Father, giver of life and health, comfort and relieve your sick servants, and give your power of healing to those who minister to their needs, that those who mourn a prayer are offered may be that those for whom our prayers are offered may be strengthened in their weakness and have confidence in your love and care. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was made. With me, oh, let it
Let us pray. Gracious and generous God, creator and giver of all that is good, we thank you for your many blessings. We acknowledge that all that we have is from you. We offer you thanks and praise for the beauty of the earth, our work, our family, and loved ones, and all the gifts that we have been given. You are with us always. In each dark hour, you are here. In each bright hour, you are here. Blessed by your grace, may we show gratitude by sharing what we have been given. By serving our brothers and sisters, we serve you. We remain ever grateful for your constant love, the gift of your Son, Jesus, and the presence of your Holy Spirit with us.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God,
Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life. But above all, for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen.
Let us pray for one another in the coming week, in the coming year. May God's Holy Spirit be greatly visited upon all who worship here today, and upon all our church family. If there is anger or pain in any of us, let it be left upon the altar. Gracious Lord, make us prayerful people. Teach us to look for your guidance in all our undertakings. May we see you this week in the faces of every family member, stranger, and friend. May we know the wonderful peace and love of God, share it with one another, and tell it out abroad.
Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make us common supplication to you. And you have promised to our well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petition as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of truth and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May Almighty God, who sent his Son to take our nature upon him, bless you in this holy season, scatter the darkness of sin, and brighten your heart with the light of his holiness.
Amen.
There's a star in the east on Christmas morn. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. It will lead to the place where the babe is born. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Leave your flocks and leave your lamb.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Leave your sheep and leave your ram. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Follow, follow. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Follow the star of Bethlehem. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. If you take good heed of the angel's word, rise up, shepherd, and follow. You'll forget your flocks, you'll forget your herds. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Leave your flocks and leave your lambs. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Leave your sheep and leave your rams. Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Announcement time. Oh, that's for me. Hold on. Okay, I will read this. It's been a pleasure to serve you while Mother Ellis was on sabbatical. You made this short walk joyous. Thank you for trusting me with your celebration and your challenges. I will pray that you continue to embody the qualities of your patron Saint Joseph, that you continue to adopt all who comes to you, that you are patient and loving with each other. And when even when you do not understand, I hope the faith and trust you have in your heart shine through your actions, your talents, as the time that you share. Blessing of the feast from me.